Hi, I'm Jen Doan, Sex and Confidence Coach, and welcome to the Bird YouTube channel. Today we're talking about arousal non-concordance. Can you break that down for me, please? Arousal non-concordance is something that Emily Nagoski talks about in her incredible book, Come As You Are. And basically, it's when your body doesn't match up with your brain, or vice versa. If you've ever been super turned on but not wet at all, or not mentally turned on but showing signs of physical arousal, then you've experienced arousal non-concordance. So the main takeaway is, whether or not someone is physically aroused is not a good indicator as to whether they are turned on or not. So why does this happen? You may be wondering why your body insists on doing the exact opposite thing you wanted to. Well, it turns out when it comes to wetness, the vagina has a mind of its own. Excuse me, now is not the time. Could you not? You can show the physiological signs of being turned on without actually being turned on, especially if something is sexually relevant. For example, it's super common to get wet during a pelvic exam or even while you're getting waxed because, in your vagina's opinion, the situation is sexually relevant since someone is near your junk. Now, this doesn't mean that you are turned on by getting all the hair ripped out of your vag. It just means that signals are being sent to your brain that is creating a genital response. Consent is key. So, how do we know when someone is turned on? Well, you ask. Wetness and erections are not a sign of being turned on. The only way to know if someone wants to have a sexual experience with you is to ask them. Hey, so I noticed that you're super hot, and I'm super hot, so I was thinking we could have hot times together? On a serious note, it's important to mention that survivors of sexual assault are often told that they weren't assaulted because they had a physiological response to the abuse. That's why it's so important that we understand arousal non-concordance and why genital response has no bearing on consent. So, what if you're turned on but not wet? And on the other side of things, don't be afraid to break out the lubricant if you're raring to go, but your body just isn't up to speed. But also make sure that you're getting enough foreplay before penetration. Clitoral stimulation can help with increased lubrication. Arousal non-concordance is nothing to be ashamed of and can affect anyone. Even though our bodies may not always act the way that we want them to, you are 100% in control of your consent. So don't be afraid to voice what you want in the moment, even if your body is on a different page. Thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like, subscribe, and follow us on Instagram for more sex and pleasure content, and I will see you in the next video. Bye, birdies!